From every country and culture in the world, food has found a way to evoke emotion, capture memories, and reinforce the bonds of family and friends. As traditions are handed down, traces of our ancestors' lives can be found in the hospitality enjoyed over a shared meal. This month on Culinary Journeys, we join Margarita Fores, voted Asia's best female chef by industry experts, as she embarks on a journey to celebrate Filipino food.
Oh, thank you.
Challenging perceptions and laying a foundation for the future of the cuisine. A capital city energized by an apparently chaotic cross-section of cultures that inhabit more than 7,000 islands in the Philippines. Centuries of Spanish rule and decades of American influence have combined to paint a complex picture of Filipino identity, making its food even harder to define. This task has fallen on the renowned chef Margarita Fores, who has drawn the spotlight to a cuisine that has long been overshadowed by its neighbors in Southeast Asia.
We have a national dessert that's called halo-halo, and I think that it best describes what our cuisine is. It's really it translates to mix-mix. There was a lot of trade between the Chinese traders and us, and eventually, when the Spaniards came and invaded us and colonized us, that was 333 years of Spanish influence, with much as well coming from Mexico because of the galleon trade, and then eventually another 48 years of American influence. So I think that putting all that together really best describes the uniqueness of what Filipino cuisine is.
From sisig to sinigang, sweet and sour flavors dominate Filipino taste buds, finding their way into almost every dish. But such flavors haven't always found favor with international food critics.
I think that they say that it's very brown. It doesn't have like a distinct quality to it. What's helped is that we Filipinos have kind of like developed a united front now to present our cuisine with a new point of view.
They ordered one spinach fettuccine bolognese.
That point of view can be seen at Fores' restaurant, Grace Park.
Grace Park gave me a chance to sort of remind us Filipinos about how we should really sort of celebrate the things that we grew up with.
For years, Filipino food has been seen as just home cooking, but it is now showing up in high-quality restaurants around the country, giving it a whole new perspective.
There's this wonderful sort of wealth of heritage in our cuisine that they sort of like took for granted.
The essence of that cuisine starts with the ingredients Fores has known her entire life.
I kind of grew up across the street, and I've been coming to the market, I guess, almost all my life. Maybe I must have started when the market opened in 1975, and it's grown so much since then. And I like to come, you know, every few days just to see what the new produce is and what's in season. Actually, the women who would take me to the market were the ladies who would cook for my grandmother at home. And they were the ones that were up early. So I would come across with them and they would introduce me to their sukis. The suki is like your best vendor who gives you like the best prices.
The farmer's market is ground zero for Fores' quest to introduce the world to Filipino food.
The avocados are in season now, and we usually don't use them for a salad. We use them for sweets. So we just mix them with milk and sugar and just eat them with a spoon or make ice cream out of it.
Her excitement is one of a proud parent.
When I'm here and I'm showing people around, I usually show them how beautiful the seafood is and that we can appreciate it and eat it immediately the way it is raw.
In an attempt to broaden her knowledge of Filipino cuisine, Fores has moved beyond markets to find farmers who have unearthed long-forgotten ingredients. One of her closest allies in this mission is farmer Jejo Jimenez.
Hi, good morning.
Great day to visit you. Happy birthday.
Thank you. Salamat.
Thank you, Papa.
So nice to see you again.
Thank you.
Hi, everybody. Kamusta?
And we just have a little souvenir for you.
Oh, thank you.
Then there's another thing that we discovered here. Remember the wild cucumbers?
Oh my gosh, yeah.
These grow wild, you know? We didn't bring the seeds here. They were just growing all around the place. And
nice and sweet.
You know, we found out that it was edible.
And oh my gosh,
really looks... nice.
I love the purslain. It's so nice because it also stands up really nicely on a plate. It doesn't wilt because it has so much water in it. And the wood sorrel, the same thing. You know, now when I harvest it, and when you do it too, you should get the entire stalk because it looks so nice and organic on the plate.
The way we do lettuce is we have all the seeds
sprouting
germinated
here
in one tray, and then we choose the ones that germinate.
And
Larry here transplants them one by one.
Oh my gosh.
To a seed tray, you know. And even the soil here is prepared. We sieve them.
That's a real labor things. Of love.
While the concept of farm to table may not be new, here in the Philippines, it has helped unify the food community in the fight to promote their cuisine worldwide.
Wow, it's been 5 years and we've shared so much stuff and really become kindred spirits, you know, with the shared advocacies.
Yeah, the diversity that works well in the farm matches the diversity
exactly. That
you need on the table.
On the table.
As our journey continues, Fores heads south to the sugar bowl of the Philippines.